Remember back to those good old days when we were approximating antiderivatives by using Euler's method?
I maybe started with some function, little f, and I wanted to numerically approximate a function big F whose derivative was little f. And maybe I know big F's value at zero is exactly zero, and I want to numerically approximate big F for values away from zero.
And then we did repeated linear approximation.
Well, I picked some tiny h, and then I approximated big F of h. Well, what do I know about big F? Big F's derivative is little f. So my approximation for big F at h is the value of big F at zero plus h times the derivative of big F at zero. Well, what is this? The value of big F at zero is exactly equal to zero. And I got plus h times, and the derivative of big F is little f. So times little f at zero. So I can use this as my approximation for big F at h.
And then I did it again.
So I want to approximate big F at 2h. Well, that's big F at h, approximately. I mean, I'm writing equals, but I really mean approximately. Big F of h plus h times the derivative of big F at h. Right? I start at f of h, and I'm going to wiggle over by h, and the derivative is encoding, at least approximately, how much the output should change for a given input change. So this is what I get by doing another linear approximation. But now I've already got an approximation for big F at h. It's h times f of 0. So I'll use that for my value of big F at h, h times f of 0 plus h times, and I know f prime of h. I know big F's derivative is little f, so I can use that here. So this is just little f at h. So this is an approximation for big F at 2h.
And then I did it a third time.
So I mean, this is the method of Euler, right? I want to approximate big F at 3h. Well, that'll be big F at 2h plus how much I wiggled by, which is h, times the derivative of big F at 2h. And what do I know? Well, I've already got an approximation for big F at 2h. It's right here. So it's h times little f of 0 plus h times little f of h plus h times. And now what's my derivative of big F at 2h? Well, big F's derivative is little f. So I can use that here. This will be little f at 2h.
And then I just keep on going.
I want to approximate big F at 10h. Right, I'd just be repeating this process. It'll be h times f of 0 plus h times f of h plus h times f of 2h. And it'll keep on going until I get to h times f of 9h.
Now, what does that look like?
This looks like a Riemann sum. Right? And I would want to choose h to be very small. So really, if I wanted to approximate big F of x using the method of Euler, I'd be using smaller and smaller values of h and calculate it like this. And what would I be calculating? I'd just be calculating the integral from 0 to x of my function, right? Of little f of t dt.
And what do I know about accumulation functions?
Well, I know that the derivative of the accumulation function, right, is the original function. And that's exactly what I want, right? I mean, this is saying that the derivative of big F is little f.
So Euler's method amounts to calculating a Riemann sum. And a Riemann sum approximates an integral, right? The accumulation function. And the accumulation function is an antiderivative. It all makes sense, right? All of these things that appear different are really the same thing. Euler's method then gives another perspective on why the fundamental theorem of calculus should be true.